Dr. Jones,
you're a man of many talents.
Hello there. I'm Ben Burtt. I'm a sound designer and supervising sound editor. And on Raiders of the Lost Ark, I partnered up with Richard Anderson, my old USC cinema pal. And together, we created the sounds for the movie, the sound effects that were done outside, trucks, explosions, fire. We came into the studio and modified things to build up the whole library for Indy. John, what did you do?
And I'm John Roesch, and I work with Joan Rowe. And we did the Foley on the picture. Ben had hired us, and we would do the things you're going to see upcoming, texture-wise, et cetera, footsteps and things like this. And hopefully, you know, what we did will help enhance the storyline where, in fact, if Foley's done where it's done well, you don't know we've done it.
Let's talk a little bit about the fight sounds in the movie, okay? One way of doing some nice body hits is to put those croquet balls here in some socks so you can get some velocity behind it here. Get some object you want to hit. Sometimes it's a piece of furniture. What would Foley be doing in one of our fight scenes?
I am glad you asked, Ben, because again, we talk about texture. So what I'd be doing, I would be setting up with, what's ubiquitous for Foley, a couple things. Number one being celery. Number two being a chamois. Take the chamois and wrap it around the celery. So we have a couple things going on here. We've got a little gush to the face. We got a little crack of the celery, and we have behind it this cushion. So when we go like this, now mind you, of course, that's one effect, so to speak. We give that to Ben. Ben puts it together with all his elements, and then you get the big punch of Indy.
Did you use celery for biting?
So you had to go there, Ben. Okay, fine. Well, all right, if I have to do it, take the celery and you get a nice crunch.
And of course, it's sword versus gun. And I had the gun sound. John, you were the sword.
I had the sword. In fact, I know it doesn't quite look like a sword. It looks like a dowel, but that's actually what it would be. Now watch yourself. I don't want to hurt you. Okay. And it'll be something like, and then of course, he shoots him, down he goes. And I might even do the sword hitting the ground too. Again, really whatever Ben wants, but Ben would send us a, a roadmap, if you would, as what he needed, and we would fulfill that.
There's a scene in the movie with snakes, thousands of snakes. And you may want to say, we had to produce the sound of many snakes slithering over each other all at once. And so we turn to something we've made a lot of use of over the years. It's my wife's, Peggy's, macaroni and cheese.
Take this. Wave it at anything that slithers.
Oh, thank God, this whole place is slithering.
You know, there's a scene where Marion and Indy are on the tramp steamer, and she hits him, by mistake, with the mirror. So, well, let's see. What are we going to use for hitting him? I've got an idea. Hold on here. I just happen to have, yes, a top of a trash can, and this will be loud. Here we go.
What'd you say?
Now, Raiders of the Lost Ark gravitates from the guns and the explosions, the fire, the mummies, to the supernatural. And at the end of the picture, we have, of course, the opening of the Ark and the ghosts coming out and all the mayhem that's created. And now, as I was making sounds for the end, I wanted something for them opening the lid of the Ark of the Covenant. And on the actual prop, Ark was just plastic. It didn't, as most props are not recordable really and used in the final movie. I wanted something that was solid. So I was sitting there one day thinking, and I came up with this sound, which was right at hand, which was my toilet tank bowl cover, okay? And this is the actual one. This is what was used for the Ark being opened in the film. So I've saved it all these years. The toilet has long since fallen apart, but in any event, it's a little blasphemous to admit this, but this is the lid of the Ark of the Covenant.
So I guess we've come to the end of our program, but let's look back a little bit. How long ago was it you did Raiders?
41 years ago, actually, started working on it, yeah.
Do you still love film?
I do. I still love it. I still love giving life to movies by adding sound, which completes the illusion. No matter what else has been done, it's not finished until the sound is there to really sell it. So that's a rewarding process. It always has been.
I second that. And thank you, Ben. You're the best. Bye, everybody.